So, this is going to be fun to translate. Do not pass go. They want a monopoly over your mind, your soul, and your body. And you want to know how you go from slinging rocks to breaking rocks, the devil's in the details, Akeem. Society will convince you to sell vows so they can send you to a cell and sell your free services like vows. You really think them judges ain't got contracts for kickbacks to manifest in all those one-size-fit-all cookie-cutter trials? Nah, for them, a slave court is like Rikers Island, just a stash, and they get to re-up immediately after they tee up with their connect at the country club. So when you standing in front of that judge, you looking like money, blood. And when you find yourself standing in front of a black robe and standing to make money off your black ass, it's probably too late to ask whether you ever really should believe that a trap house could be the way out. See, the funny thing about traps is eventually everybody get to play the mouse. Serve fiends, serve time, become a purveyor of free goods and services, go from being your own man to one of the private prison industrial complexes, human purchasers, money worshippers, tend to end their story as inventory. Them cell block tears be like shells, and them jumpsuits and barcoded bracelets, that'll be your packaging. And this ain't the first time they stacked Africans, but perhaps one of the first times that some of us was half volunteering. Like, we prefer the company of a cellmate to that of our soulmate and our children. Pardon self, I love you, bro. You gonna do what you gonna do, but prior to I get to speak my piece is each one teach one in this belly of the beast. And that crime bill should have been subtitled incarcerate as many black men as possible and make it damn near impossible for them to get released. These days, they'll get you if you waver. They'll enslave you while you're on the fence. And the next thing you'll hear is, excuse me, Your Honor, I represent the defense. And I believe this is the part of the trial. We just automatically ask for a plea bargain. I'm a public defender, so it makes my job easier if I just convince them that even though there's no real evidence against them, this jury will be filled with white senior citizens, housing crisis victims who would love to take it out on a black man but can't lynch him, so the next best thing is to vindictively convict them. Look, listen, bruh. Right. Keep your head up. Okay. Learn the skill. We all fed up, but what's real is there ain't no easy way. You either stand out here and grind with the rest of us, or you chase that trap and be a slave. Pardon me, but I was under the impression that select members of the Council of Foreign Relations were being kept alive using the harvested body organs of missing Black Lives Matter protesters. Particularly now that we've arrived at the point in history where pro-black activists and white supremacist organizers are both being funded by billionaire investors. We're back to that civil war by proxy paradigm, and in the words of Robert Nesta Marley, I shot the sheriff, but I did not shoot the deputy.
Right.
Especially since the deputies have been manipulated to believe that it's not the rich and powerful, but instead it's the tragically powerless brown and black people to keep holding them back. When the fact is, where they get trapped is when the rich and powerful engage strategists and propagandists to help stoke that fear, got them working against their own best interests, supporting billion and multimillionaires, even though they intend to take away their children, grandchildren, and grandparents' health care. Got them cheering on the dissolution of entitlements when lower class whites are the largest recipients of social services and welfare. It's just like that housing crisis. They gonna lose everything trying to believe that the wealthy care less about becoming wealthier than they care about some imaginary covenant with whiteness. And the extent to which they believe these alternative facts is the extent to which they will continue to join the authentic homeless. And yet they wanna put the onus on us. That's why sometimes you gotta break it to them, like, check this out, man. Your ancestors might have been a lot of things. Indentured servants, immigrants, but come on. You know there wasn't no goddamn slave owners. How many generations in your family had trust funds? Back when my ancestors were being exploited on the plantation, them same slave owners considered your ancestors scum, who at best could hope to be bootlickers for the rich or hire guns. In other words, back in slavery times, your ancestors were relegated to dwell in American and European slums and ain't eat that much better than mine. Lower class white people were considered expendable, dying for pennies, fighting to keep their families alive, meant more than 9 to 5, in order to survive through a diamond, they had to scrape by on whatever jobs they could find. That's why I make America great again is an insult. Because it insinuates that y'all forgot the 1% been running this the whole time.
Right.
The Bilderbergs and Trilateralists been understood the advantages of allowing the lower classes of white people to struggle just a little less than everyone else. That within and of itself, just like that income tax scheme and a Federal Reserve scheme, is a gold mine. Open secret. In order for the 1% to continue to quietly attend events like the World Economic Forum, they need to distract your mind. So they empower a few of the white chess pieces, empower a few of the black chess pieces, then they haul out this goofy ass who owes them billions of dollars, and once they convince the masses that his bought and sold dumbass has been elected president, boom! It's showtime. Thank you.